Do you recognize this guy? In case you don't, his name is Brian Koberger. On November 13th last year, four students were murdered in Idaho. Three girls and one guy, aged 20 and 21, stabbed to death. Dreadful crime. Brian Koberger has been arrested and charged and is so far the only suspect. He's also been convicted, not by the courts, but by the media, by people who should know better, including police officers, at least one former judge, although in the United States a former judge is still alluded to as judge, many others, which, you know, why should there be a trial? Now, I'm not going to comment on the strength of the case against him. What I'm going to do is draw a comparison with a case that happened in England back in the 1940s, an even more terrible case, because although the man concerned was convicted only of one murder, he undoubtedly killed many more. Here he is. If you don't recognise him, or even if you do, his name was John George Haig. Generally in England we don't allude to convicted murderers by three names, as they do in the United States. John Haig, well, anyway, he was known as the acid bath murderer. At that time it was standard when somebody was charged with more than one murder to try him for one murder and then another. For example, in the 1950s, Dr. Bodkin Adams was charged with two murders. He was tried for one, acquitted, rightly so, and then the prosecution dropped the second case. Haig, though, is a very different kettle of fish. He murdered for money, basically. After his arrest, the Daily Mirror newspaper of March the 4th, 1949, reported not that he was charged with other murders, but that he had committed other murders. It gave the names of the victims and the descriptions of these alleged murders. Haig hoped to escape the hangman's noose by claiming sanity, claiming to have been a vampire, to drink the blood of his victims. He didn't get away with it, fortunately. Not that madness should excuse this kind of carnage. But while he was in prison, from his cell in Lewis Prison, Haig brought two motions for writs of attachment for contempt of court against the Daily Mirror. Lord Justice Goddard, sitting with Mr. Justice Humphreys, and Mr. Justice Burkitt heard this application, and it announced that the publication of a statement which may prejudice in any way the fair conduct of a case, whether civil or criminal, is a plain abuse of the right to report news freely. The Mirror's contempt was said to have violated every principle of justice and fair play, which has been the pride of this country to extend to the worst of criminals. A gross contempt. Echoing the words of Lord Hardwicke from 1742, a case of prejudicing mankind against persons before their case is heard. The editor of the Daily Mirror, Sylvester Bolam, was given a 3-month prison sentence. Here is part of one report from the regional press, the Courier and Advertiser, Dundee, 2nd edition, March 26, 1949, page 3. You can read up on this case elsewhere on the internet. I said I wouldn't comment on the strength of the case against Brian Koberger, but the case against Haig was even stronger. Yet the editor of the newspaper, Daily Mirror, was sent to prison for contempt, and also the paper was fined. Now, let's look beyond the Koberger case to another case of trial by media. Bill Cosby, remember him? The public perception of Bill Cosby is that he is a serial rapist. That is bunk. With one exception, Andrea Constand, a case of very reasonable doubt because she reported this alleged sexual assault months later, and she'd been drinking alcohol at the time, on mixing alcohol and drugs, legal drugs. With that one exception, all Cosby's accusers are liars, whores, mad women. He was convicted because the odious Gloria Allred orchestrated a hate campaign against him. I've made two videos on this subject. If you get a chance, if you get the time rather, check out The Prior Bad Acts of Gloria Allred, which you'll find at the Internet Archive and on BitChute. The Prior Bad Acts of Gloria Allred. And if you haven't got a lot of time, just look at the press conference Allred gave with Linda Ridgway White Deer, and ask yourself how the assorted press plebs didn't burst out laughing when this woman described what she said Cosby had done to her. Cosby has since been cleared, but not vindicated, and he's still being pursued by these hags. This is why we don't have trial by media. In the courtroom, there are rules of evidence and procedure, inadequate though they may be. A lot of evidence is excluded as prejudicial because it isn't really evidence, because it's hearsay. It may be a lot of genuine evidence is excluded, but this is the price we pay for a proper criminal justice system, proper in quotation marks. Without it, we have mob rule. It's only one step from the media lynching of Koberger to an actual lynching. So, to my American correspondents, I would say, tell the media to shut the fuck up when it comes to cases like this. In Britain, if Koberger had been arrested for such crimes, there would have been a statement by the police. And after that, there had been very limited reporting until the actual trial. Fair and accurate reporting, subject to the 1981 Contempt of Court Act. There has been a gagging order in place of sorts. I don't know how it's been observed, but you know, if this guy is guilty, will the next one be? And if you think innocent people aren't accused of crimes falsely, and if you think innocent people don't confess falsely, you haven't got much experience, because they do confess to crimes, and innocent people are fitted up by the police, and innocent people are convicted on apparently compelling evidence, which is then found to be not so compelling. So again, tell your media to shut the fuck up and let this case proceed the way it would have proceeded in the UK. That's all I have to say.